For those of you who know me, you knew this was coming. For those of you who don't, you'll learn. My name is Ash, and this is Lara Croft Tomb Raider 2001 movie review. Based on the most successful interactive video game character of all time, Lara Croft Tomb Raider 2001 is an action-adventure film starring Angelina Jolie as Lara Croft, a dual-pistol-wielding archaeologist trying to stop the Illuminati from finding and reuniting two halves to a sacred object known as the Triangle of Light, an object with the ability to control time, and gives its possessor power that can be used for good or great evil. The filmmakers did their homework. They maintained the core elements of Tomb Raider. They kept this film as close to the Tomb Raider canon as possible between the comic books and the video games. The filmmakers even recreated scenes from the video games and put them in the film. For example, the infamous shower scene was inspired by the ending cutscene from the game Tomb Raider 2 starring Lara Croft. This film has one of the best opening sequences ever done. The title of the film appears in the pupil of Lara's eye as she's suspended upside down on a rope that she then backflips off of. Fun fact, director Simon West actually made an alternate version to this film, which he has yet to release. Please, Mr. West, if you are watching this, release it. I want to see it so hard. I would probably cry. The film was well-directed and has stunning cinematography. This film is aesthetically pleasing. The scenes of the temple ruins, shot on location in Angkor Wat, are a work of art. Tomb Raider was the first major motion picture to film at Angkor Wat Temple in Cambodia since 1964. This film introduced Cambodia to an entire generation that was previously unaware of this beautiful and culturally rich country. They even added in flashbacks to explain the backstory. The filmmakers even threw in the foreboding music that plays before Lara falls into the Tomb of the Dancing Light, similar to when the foreboding music would play in the games when Lara would trigger a trap or whenever the floor would fall out from underneath her. This film was a continuation into the already vast Tomb Raider universe. It wasn't a remake, it wasn't a relaunch, it was bringing Lara Croft to the big screen. Not only was the purpose of the film to bring Lara Croft to the big screen, there was also deeper meaning behind it. The film was about more than Lara saving the world and defeating the villains. The film was about a daughter's love for her father, a daughter trying to reconnect and regain lost time. Lara ultimately has to decide whether she will be selfless, destroy the triangle and save the world, or to be selfish and to use the triangle to regain the time that she lost with her father. This led to a very real moment between John Voight and Angelina Jolie, a real-life father and daughter that have an estranged relationship, in a scene towards the end of the film where Lara finally reunites with her father. During the scene, Richard Croft convinces Lara to destroy the triangle and to save the world, despite Lara's yearning for more time with her father. This scene could have either gone very well or badly. In this case, it went well, especially considering that John Voight and Angelina Jolie are both incredibly talented actors. And for a while, this film did help repair their relationship. By far, the best part of this film was the acting. Tomb Raider in and of itself is a magical film, but she adds this special kind of magic. Angelina Jolie busted her ass for this role. She put a lot of work in to become Lara Croft, and she was incredibly successful. She knew how huge the fan base was for the Tomb Raider franchise. She knew what was on the line. People underestimate the amount of work she put into this role. She did weapons training with the SAS, which is the British Special Forces, fight training, workouts, dietary changes, and cultural education, all to become Lara Croft. Fun fact, Angelina Jolie did her own stunts for this film. Tomb Raider was a turning point for Angelina, not just in her career, but in her daily life. This role ignited the humanitarian flame inside her soul. It was a beautiful metamorphosis to watch as a fan. Angelina Jolie is Lara Croft. The film was kept very close to Tomb Raider canon. They kept the braid, the boots, the backpack, the gun belt with the double thigh holsters and accompanying dual pistols. The color changes with Lara's outfit from the games to the film just gave Lara a new look. Lara did change outfits frequently in the games. Lara went from the Indiana Jones-style mint green tank top with the khaki shorts and the brown boots and the brown backpack to an almost combat tactical style with black boots, black t-shirt, black shorts, black backpack. The guns were similar in style to those featured in the game. An example for my upcoming video. In Chapter 5 of the film, 40 minutes and 40 seconds to 41 minutes and 17 seconds, Lara is using binoculars to spy on Manfred Powell and Alex West as they try to open the Tomb of the Dancing Light. She raises the binoculars, and then we get a point of view shot of what she sees through the binoculars as she spies on West and Powell. Then the camera goes back to her, and then again gives us another point of view shot of what she sees through the binoculars. This is almost an identical shot for shot of the cutscene before level 11, the base, in Tomb Raider Chronicles. Another example for the sake of argument. One of the best action sequences in the entire film is when Lara is in the Tomb of the Dancing Light recovering the first piece of the Triangle of Light. After retrieving the piece, she awakens a multiple-faced, multiple-armed Brahmin statue that she must battle. This scene also happens to be a recreation from the games. Cambodia was featured in the first level of the fourth Tomb Raider game, Tomb Raider: Last Revelation, and multiple armed Brahmin statues that came to life and attacked Lara were also featured in the third installment of the game series, Tomb Raider: The Adventures of Lara Croft. The film was geared towards the same audience as the video games, which would have been the older teen and adult demographic. And they nailed it. This is by far the best video game to live action film adaptation ever done. I will be explaining why with examples in a later video. This is my favorite film of all time, special mention to The Mummy 1999. I loved this film so much I went to see it 7 times in theaters. Yes, 7 times in theaters, and I do still have my movie stubs. When I saw this film for the first time, I was blown away. I was very young and I fell head over heels in love with Tomb Raider and Angelina Jolie at the same time. This film is beautiful and exciting, and this is a treasured work of art to me. This is a true action-adventure film. It belongs up there with the greats like the Indiana Jones series. I highly recommend it. I give the film 5 stars, 2 thumbs way, way up, and an A+++++. Watch it multiple times. It's worth it. For those of you haters out there saying things like, nobody likes this film, well, to that I say, a girl is no one. Thank you all so much for watching, and if you would like to see me again, please click the like and subscribe button. Good night.